हाई डेंटिस्ट, इट्स पीयूष हियर। लेट्स लर्न फार्माकोलॉजी टॉपिक लोकल एनेस्थीजिया, आल्सो कॉल्ड एज एलए। लोकल एनेस्थीजिया आर द ड्रग्स विच अपॉन ट्रॉपिकल एप्लीकेशन और लोकल इंजेक्शन कॉज रिवर्सिबल लॉस ऑफ सेंसरी परसेप्शन। द एसेंशियल्स ऑफ पेन इन अ रिस्ट्रिक्टेड एरिया ऑफ द बॉडी, दे ब्लॉक जर्नेशन एंड कंडक्शन ऑफ द नर्व इम्पल्सिस एट एनी पार्ट ऑफ द न्यूरोन with which they come in contact without causing any structural damage. Properties desirable in a local anesthesia: it should be non-irritating, it does not cause permanent damage to the nerve endings, the systemic toxicity should be low, effective in injected as well as locally applied, onset of action as slow as possible, and DOA long enough to allow the time for the contemplated surgery. Let's see the difference between general and local anesthesia. The site of action: the GA, which is called a general anesthesia, act on the CNS, whereas the LA act on the peripheral nerves. The area of body involved is totally different. As general anesthesia, the site of action is CNS, so whole body is involved. In case of local anesthesia, as site of action is peripheral nerves, so the restricted areas of that nerve will be involved. The consciousness is lost in the general anesthesia and it is unaltered in case of the local anesthesia one. The care of vital functions is essential in general, but they are not that much needed in case of local anesthesia. The pathological trespass is high in general anesthesia, but it is low in the local one. Poor health patients are very risky in case of general, but it's safe in case of local anesthesia. Use in non-cooperative patient, general anesthesia is the best option, but the local anesthesia, there are certain factors to counter non-cooperative patients. And the major surgeries are performed under general anesthesia and the minor one, local anesthesia is preferred. Classification of local anesthesia: it is very important because a 10-mark question comes as classify local anesthesia and write the mechanism of action of lignocaine. It is divided broadly into two classifications as injectable anesthetics and surface anesthetic. The injectables one have again three subtypes as low potency and short duration, intermediate potency and duration, high potency and long duration. The surface anesthetics are divided into two as soluble and insoluble. Local anesthesia can also be divided based upon the chemistry of the anesthetic as ester-linked local anesthesia and amide-linked local anesthesia. The features of amide-linked local anesthesia as compared to that of the ester-linked local anesthesia: it produces more intense and long-lasting anesthetics, and it binds to alpha-1 acid glycoprotein in the plasma, and it is not hydrolyzed by the plasma esterases, and whereas the ester-linked get hydrolyzed by the plasma esterases. And they rarely produce hypersensitivity reaction, and there is no cross sensitivity with the ester-linked local anesthesia. Therefore, the amide-linked local anesthesia are preferred instead of the ester-linked local anesthesia. Mechanism of action: it is very important. Local anesthesia block the nerve conduction by decreasing the entry of the sodium ions during the upstroke of the action potential. As the concentration of local anesthesia is increased, the rate of rise in the action potential and the maximum depolarization, both of them decreases, causing slowing of the conduction. Therefore, the local depolarization fails to reach the threshold potential and the conduction is blocked. At physiologic pH, local anesthesia molecule is partly ionized. That means there are two forms that exist in equilibrium, that are unionized form and the ionized form. The unionized form is capable of penetrating the axonal membrane, but the active species is the ionized form, and in it is the cationic form. The ionic form will bind to the receptor only when the channel is open at the inner phase, and it binds rapidly to the activated as well as inactivated state of the channel as compared to the resting state, which is rather resistant to the blockage. Order of blockage and the order of recovery: first the autonomic will be blocked, then after pain, temperature, touch, deep pressure. At the end, the motor will be blocked. And in case of the order of recovery, it is the reverse one, that of the order of blockage. A question comes to our mind, if we are saying that local anesthesia will relieve the pain, then why so that the pain is not controlled in case of the inflamed tissues like that of the infected teeth? There are such reasons because of which the local anesthesia fails. They are such as the inflammation causes pH to decrease of that tissue. So because of that lower pH, there will be the greater fraction of the local anesthesia will be in the ionized form, which is not capable of crossing or diffusion into the axonulima, and that result into the unfunctional of that of the local anesthesia. If the blood flow to the infected area is increased, the local anesthesia will be removed rapidly from that site, and effectiveness of the adrenaline injected with local anesthesia is reduced at the inflamed tissue, and the inflammatory products may oppose the local anesthesia action. That is the addition of vasoconstrictors. Example is adrenaline that is added in ratio of 1:50,000 to 1:200,000. Systemic action. Local anesthesia in any form will ultimately absorb into the circulation, and they will produce systemic effect depending upon the concentration attained in the plasma or the tissues. In CNS, all anesthetic will produce a sequence of stimulation followed by depression, which will be dependent upon the dose manner. And the cocaine is a powerful CNS stimulant, and it causes sequence as euphoria, excitement, mental confusion, restlessness, tremor and twitching of the muscles, convulsions, unconsciousness, and ultimately respiratory depression and death, which will be of dose dependent nature or dose dependent manner. CVS hurt, it will be affected as cardiac depressant, but no significant effects are observed at conventional doses. Inocaine, which is a local anesthesia, is used as antiarrhythmic drug. Blood vessels, local anesthesia tend to produce fall in blood pressure. Pharmacokinetic, it is not important determinant of their efficacy because local anesthesia act near their site of administration, but it is markedly influence their systemic effects and systemic toxicity. The soluble surface anesthetics such as lignocaine, tetracaine are rapidly absorbed from the mucous membranes and the abraded areas, but absorption from the intact skin is minimal. The combination with vasoconstrictor that result in reduction in the blood flow and reduces the rate of systemic absorption, and it diminishes the peak serum levels and decreases the toxicity. More the repeat solubility of the drug, longer will be the action. The amidling local anesthetics can be widely distributed via circulation. Adverse effects of local anesthetic. CNS effects are lightheadedness, dizziness, auditory and visual disturbances, mental confusion, disorientation, shivering, twitching, involuntary movements, finally convulsions and respiratory arrest. Cardiovascular toxicity of local anesthesia is manifested as bradycardia, hypertension, cardiac arrhythmias and vascular collapse. Injection may be painful, but local tissue toxicity is low and the wound healing may be sometimes delayed. Hypersensitivity reactions like rashes, angioedema, dermatitis, contact sensitization, asthma and rarely anaphylaxis may occur. Motor paralysis can occur and hematologic effects can be there. Prevention of toxicity. History of any allergy. Causation in presence of liver or myocardial damage. Proper site of administration. For that, correct knowledge of the nerve course should be there. And minimum effective dose should be used. Wait after the injection. Observe the face of the patient for any twitching, excitement and pulse for tachycardia. Observe post-op for allergic reactions. Avoid food intake at least 4 hours to anesthesia to prevent vomiting and to prevent cheek biting. Question comes in our mind, can we administer the local anesthesia to the pregnant woman? Yes, we can, as local anesthesia are not teratogenic and can be administered to the pregnant patient in usual clinical doses, but the large doses of paraloxane are known to cause methemoglobinemia, which cause maternal and fetal hypoxia. Local anesthesia along with vasoconstrictor like Adderall is most common local anesthetic used in dentistry, extensively used in pregnancy with no proven ill effects. In this picture, they are giving local anesthesia to the incisive papilla. Commonly a FIMA question comes as, why lignocaine is preferred over procaine as local anesthetic agent? Lignocaine produces more intense and long-lasting anesthesia. The hypersensitivity reactions are very rare and it blocks the conduction within 3 minutes while procaine takes 15 minutes to block. It does not show cross-sensitivity with ester-linked local anesthetics. It is used for surface anesthesia, nerve block, epidural and spinal anesthesia. While procaine is poorly absorbed from the mucous membrane and cannot be used topically. More often, a FIMA question comes as, what preference of adrenaline with lignocaine or why we combine adrenaline with lignocaine? It prolongs duration of action of local anesthesia by decreasing their rate of removal from the local site into the circulation. Contact time of local anesthesia with the nerve is increased and it enhances the intensity of the nerve block. It reduces systemic toxicity of local anesthesia as the rate of absorption is reduced and metabolism keeps the plasma concentration to lower level. It provides a more bloodless field for the surgery. It increases the chances of subsequent local tissue edema and necrosis, as well as delays wound healing by reducing oxygen supply and ensuring oxygen consumption in the affected area, may raise blood pressure and promote arrhythmia in susceptible individuals. Lidocaine, also called as lignocaine, it is currently the most widely used local anesthesia as it is the versatile local anesthesia because it is good both for the surface application as well as for the injection, and it is available in variety of the formulations. Injected around the nerve, it blocks the conduction within 3 minutes, whereas procaine takes 15 minutes to block. Vasodilation occurs in the injected area. It is used for surface application, infiltration, nerve block, epidural, spinal and intravenous regional block anesthetic. Cross-sensitivity with ester-linked local anesthesia is not seen. In contrast to other local anesthetics, early central effects of lignocaine are depression, that is, dizziness, mental clouding, dysphoria, altered taste, and tinnitus. Overdose cause muscle twitching, convulsions, cardiac arrhythmia, fall in BP, coma, and respiratory arrest like that of the other local anesthetics. And lignocaine is a popular anti-arrhythmic drug. A transdermal patch of lignocaine has been produced for application over the affected area for relief of the burning pain due to post-therapeutic neuralgia. Atracane, also called as amitocaine, a highly lipid-soluble PABA ester, more potent and more toxic due to slow hydrolysis by plasma pseudochloroesterases. It is both surface and conduction block anesthetic, but its use is restricted to topical application to the eye, nose, throat, tracheobronchial tree, and rarely for the spinal or caudal anesthetics for the long duration. Even if it is a slow acting, absorption from the tracheobronchial spray is very fast and blood concentration approaches to that obtained after the intravenous injection. Uses of local anesthesia, surface anesthesia, infiltration anesthesia, conduction block, in which it is of two types, field block and nerve block, spinal anesthesia, and last is epidural anesthesia. Complications of spinal anesthesia, respiratory paralysis. With proper care, it is very rare. The intercostal muscles may be paralyzed, but diaphragm maintains the breathing as it is supplied by the phrenic nerve. Hypotension is due to the blockage of the systemic vasoconstrictor outflow to the blood vessels. The venous pooling and decreased return to the heart contributes more to the fall in the blood pressure than the arterial dilatation. Headache is due to the spasms of the CVS and can be minimized by using smaller Bose needle. Cauda equina syndrome is a rare neurological complication resulting in prolonged loss of control over bladder and bowel sphincter. Septic meningitis, it may occur due to infection introduced during the lumbar puncture. Nausea and vomiting after abdominal operation is due to the reflexes triggered by the traction on the abdominal viscera. Thanks. Make sure to share the knowledge with your friends. Keep supporting.